Are we finally saying goodbye to the open policy agent? Can Kubernetes now properly allocate my GPU resources? Hey, Pixelers. Michael Haddon here. Today I thought it'd be interesting to have a quick peek on a few game-changing features in the new Kubernetes 1.26 release. The first one that I'm excited to talk about is the validating emission policies. This is still in alpha and disabled by default, but I think it might end up being a staple of Kubernetes cluster management going forward. It allows you to easily roll out cluster-wide policies to ensure created resources meet compliance. No third-party policy manager or custom Golang code is required. Here is an example policy declaration. My favorite part is how easy it is to read and write, and not only that, it's really expressive. The purpose of this code is exactly what you think. Ensure, whenever a deployment is created or updated, that the specified replicas is less or equal to 5. You can customize the expression using the Common Expression Language, or CEL, which I think is much simpler than its competitors. After making the policy, you can easily configure which resources it manages by creating a policy binding. Integrating features like this, which are normally offloaded to third-party developers, is probably a really good idea as it helps standardize and simplify the Kubernetes ecosystem. Let me know what you guys think. I'm excited to see this released as stable, and if you are too, be sure to check out the official documentation down in the description. The second one is the new dynamic resource allocation. Essentially, they have taken the disk resource management and made it generic and extensible. This means we can create our own custom resource allocation drivers, or more likely, we can just install something else that someone's already written. But you can imagine the possibilities. For example, if you want to partially allocate GPU resources across pods, the definition could look like this. So far, there is no example implementation of the driver. However, the link to the placeholder GitHub repository will be down in the description. Lastly, Microsoft has been working hard to implement the Windows equivalent to Linux privileged containers in Kubernetes. You can now define your pod to run its containers as host processes by simply configuring a pod's security context, like this. A detailed configuration guide can be found down in the description. This is something that I think will completely change how we see running Windows Kubernetes clusters, as now administrative tasks can be performed directly within Kubernetes itself. For example, security patches, event log collection, installing Windows services, configuring keys, certificates, configuring networking change. You get the idea. Much, much more. No update is without its worries and concerns. The legacy authentication methods for Azure and gCloud have finally been removed. So, if your package manager is being a bit proactive, you'll be getting errors like this. The GCP auth plugin has been removed. Make sure to check out the documentation. There is a lot of cool stuff, like job tracking, advancements in traffic engineering, new pod scheduling, and much more granular CPU scheduling. Also, remember that excitement unfortunately doesn't magically make alpha features stable in production. Thanks for checking out this video. As always, I hope you guys have a lovely day. Cheers!